Friday lunch, Friday lunch. Made it through the week and you didn't get punched. World's gone crazy, but I got a hunch we'll all feel better after Friday lunch.
Hello and welcome to Friday Lunch, a show dedicated to featuring the best musicians and music in East Nashville and beyond. With me is my very special guest, DeMarco Johnson. DeMarco, how's it going, brother?
It's going great. How are you, Korby?
Great. I'm doing really well, man.
Good.
You said 8 months since we last saw each other.
It's probably been longer than that. I was just kind of giving it a guesstimate.
Ballparking it.
But
we've known each other for a minute. You wouldn't know it. You wouldn't know it because every time's brand new. But I want to say like 10 years maybe. And I can't even.
Oh, easily.
Yeah, enough that I don't even know what the circumstances were when we first met. I just knew how, you know, they say like people don't remember what you say or your ideas, but they remember how you make them feel.
Exactly.
And the very first time I saw you, I was like, this is a dude I can be comfortable
with. Oh, my goodness. I'm so humbled by that.
Yeah. Oh, dude. I mean, I think that that's a universal opinion of you.
And, well, I know a few people who might disagree with that.
Well, but, they're not welcome here.
But they don't count today.
I want to talk to you a little bit about kind of like what got you into music. I'm just genuinely curious, but let's play a song first.
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay. This is a song I done made up with my friend Lucas Lee, and it's called Hurts Me So. Someone give me a speaking spell, cause I can't talk for all my crying. Looked up and the sky just fell. I feel like I was struck by lightning. I can't sleep, I can't breathe. I call VE empty and tell them that I am dying of a heart attack. I never thought it would be this bad. It just hurts. It just hurts. It just hurts me so. It just hurts me so. Never thought it would end like this. Our first kiss was a supernova. Intense like a hypnotist. I said you lay in my palm like a four-leaf clover. My love has run out. There is enough to die out. I love you around. Won't think that I'm all alone. I got nobody to call my own. It just hurts. Oh, it just hurts me. It just hurts me so. It just hurts me so. And I thought that an angel would come and save me. No, 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 no. And I found out the devil was a lady. And someone give me a push and shove. Cause all this love is making me crazy. I always thought that you got my back, but you were laughing at me like a Halloween baby. You are a roller coaster, I'm a roller coaster. You are the telephone pole, I am the show poster. Big letters on the hat show print. And everywhere I look, so I can't forget. It just hurts. Oh, it just hurts me. Yeah, it just hurts me so.
Yeah,
that one was lively. I even messed the line up, but I'm just gonna leave it in there because that's what this show's about. It's about feelings more than accuracy. You could say I made a whole career out of that like sentiment
versus accuracy.
Okay, dude, let's get into it for a second. Where are you from around here?
I am not from around here. I am from Northern Indiana.
In what like Gary area or?
It is a little town called South Bend, Indiana.
South Bend, yeah.
Home of Notre Dame.
Why? What shenanigans led you to this questionable line of activity in music?
Just loving music from probably birth.
And were your parents good at it? Were they like, was there music in the house?
Lots of music in the house.
Yeah.
Very musical family. My dad is one of seven, and they all sang or played. He played
Yeah.
piano in particular. and my mom was a good singer as well. And so we always had music. They always bought music. And man, there was always music in the house.
Yeah.
And so from the time that I was little, they said that was the one thing that got my attention more than most anything else.
And was there like a record that stands out in your childhood mind that was like,
oh,
that was talked about, or that was like a...
Oh my goodness, you're going to make me date myself. And dude, I'm not going to do it.
Let's date it.
I'm not going to do
okay,
it.
Okay, well.
But
I mean,
but,
that record could have been old when you were listening to it. You know what I mean?
True.
Just because it
perhaps
came across your plate.
Well, what I will say is because we love so many different styles.
Mm.
The artist that immediately got my attention from the time I was very, very small was Stevie Wonder.
Oh, man. That's not dating yourself. That's a...
Well, that was a safe answer.
Okay.
And so, and my mother was a fan of his, you know, coming up. And in fact, she saw him at the Motortown Review in Chicago.
Dang.
In the early 60s. I don't think his voice had even changed yet.
Wow.
And so she was a lifelong fan of his. And so I had all of his music in my ears from the time I was little.
I mean, that explains a lot of the funky.
Well, you know, he was the first one I ever wanted to be. First hero that I ever was like, okay, I want to be like him.
So when did you come to Nashville?
Boy, let's see. How long has Hay been brown? No. late 90s. Got here late 90s.
Okay.
Yeah.
Just in time for the show. I don't know what that means.
Well, you know, some sort of show.
Was there a gig that pulled you here, or did you like, you know, just go, I'm going?
You know, I had been contemplating and edging toward it for about 3 years.
Yeah.
In the mid 90s, I had some very, very close friends move down here. And so I already had some people who were here, and I'd come to visit the city and see what they were doing. And I actually did not have a gig when I came down here. In fact, the first 8 months I lived here, I worked in an office. I worked an office job.
Sure.
And wasn't really hotly pursuing music, but I knew that I needed to be somewhere where there was music for me to blossom.
Yeah.
And so probably within the first year I was here, I got a tour with a contemporary Christian artist.
So you didn't move here for music originally? I mean, kind of, but not
I
like...
I did. You know, I moved here with music in mind.
Yeah.
But I didn't move here because I had something.
Yeah.
But I moved here because I wanted to be where music was. And also, having visited the city quite a bit, I liked the vibe of it. It seemed to fit my own personal rhythm as well. So.
Yeah, I was going to ask you, why Nashville and not, you know, Chicago or New York or...
You know, I had, being from Northern Indiana, I spent a lot of time in Chicago. In fact, I had relatives who lived there.
Yeah.
And so, that was too close. That was, you know.
You could come home on the weekends if you had to.
And plus the vibe was, I needed a different vibe. You know, that was Midwest.
Yeah.
And I had visited LA and spent some time out there. And, it was just a little too vast, a little bit too small, too big, you know, and then it was
a little too
and also it was super far away from my loved ones.
Yeah.
And New York was cool, but it was a little bit edgy for me.
Uh-huh.
And what my own personal vibe is.
Yeah, you're a chill guy, man. You're like
I've always been that, even when I was a little guy.
Yeah.
And so this seemed to fit. This city seemed to fit me.
Nice.
And I've been here ever since.
I mean, I, you know, tell everybody that it's just such a great town to live in because it's such a combination of, I mean, career-wise, if you're in music,
right,
top of the game. I mean, there's no better musicians.
Oh, my goodness.
Here.
Man, absolutely.
And then lifestyle-wise, you can, I mean, you're 10 minutes away from everything.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
Yeah.
No wonder everybody's moving here. Don't come. You're
don't,
fine
don't,
where
yeah,
you
just stay where you are. Stay where you are, but.
Okay, I want to edit that. Okay. Well, let's play another song.
Let's play another
fellas,
song.
I'm having such a good time here.
What should we play, Corey?
Let's play Last Man Standing.
I had a question for you about this. Are you of Native American heritage?
No, not at all. But I grew up in southern Idaho. And
that's pretty much
white bread down up there, over there. And but when I was a kid growing up, that you know, Native Americans were the people that people would talk smack about.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember being like, I could have just easily been born Native American, as white as anything. And then I read this book called Bury My Heart at Wounded Knee a couple years ago. Heavy book, really amazing book to read of American history, and kind of chronicling some of the highlights of, you know, the outrages that mm-hmm. were visited upon Native American people. And that book really touched me. And, you know, I don't, if I have a cause in that department, it does seem to be revolve around the plight of Native American people. And one of my good friends, Bill Miller, he and I have made a bunch of music together. I don't know if you know Bill. He's a Native American and a really gifted artist. But yeah, this song kind of came out of that spirit. So,
well, I asked that because my two of my 8 great grandparents are full-blooded Choctaw.
Oh, wow.
And so I was just like, well, maybe Korby has some lineage in that too.
Yeah.
You know,
well, I mean, and he's hiding it real well.
Well, we're all mixed up, so we're all mixed up.
Truly. I need to take one of those 23andMe tests just to find out. You know, might be some surprises in there. All right, let's try this one.
Mother, let me tell you something. White people gonna know my name. The big general think he up and coming. That man guy, nothing. I had a vision in the middle of the night. Yeah. The great spirit coming down on me. So custom in for a big surprise. A bullet between his eyes. Last man standing. Even if you break my heart, even if you take my land, yeah. Standing, you say you want what's mine. Whoa, well, I ain't gonna give it to you. This reservation is the choke chain cutter. This reservation is closing in. But I ain't gonna let no great white father tell me who I am. I am the leader. One Sioux nation, born free on the prairie wind. Then I signed the treaty of 68, and it all come to nothing. They took it on last man standing. Even if you break my heart, even if you take my land, yeah, I am last man standing. You better take my life. Whoa.
Sweaty on that one.
Feeling it.
Yeah, man. This is so fun, guys. It's, one of the joys of doing this every week is an excuse to get together with my friends who happen to be the most talented people anywhere. And then we get to make music together.
It's great.
What's not to like? So what's going on? What's keeping you busy these days? You told me that you're like in the middle of learning, you know, 60 songs.
Yeah.
And that's kind of a day in the life of you, I feel like.
Well, sometimes I'm more busy, sometimes I'm less busy. Mm-hmm. But getting out and doing some shows with some different people.
Can I ask a couple of, like, you know, you've played with so many people. Drop some names for me just for fun. Like some of the highlights, just whatever comes to mind. I mean, you've played probably for hundreds of artists.
Possibly.
Yeah.
Possibly.
Definitely more than 100.
It's been a long road. It's been great. Yeah. I loved it. Wow. Gosh, Kenny Loggins, Michael McDonald.
Oh, already.
Temptations.
Go on.
I'm glad you said that after we played a few.
Gosh,
I'm so nervous.
Oh my goodness. I mean, it's been great. Yeah. Great journey. It's kind of hard to kind of say, okay, this is it, because it's still evolving. I'm still playing with new people and different people.
No, that's what I love about you. You're absolutely in the mix, man. And you know, once, like, maybe a lot of times you get, you know, great gigs, pay well and pay a couple months of mortgage or more, but also you'll take gigs like, you know, we've played together a lot and you're not getting a mortgage payment out of from the gig with Korby Langer. But that's what I love about you, man. You're really very much in the spirit of music for its own sake.
Man, I love music. I always have. I always knew I would do it, and I can't see myself doing anything else. Back in the day, Michael Jordan had a clause in his contract that he could play anywhere, anytime, with anybody. Huh. Called it the love of the game clause in his contract. And I really embrace that. I'm like, the love of music. Mm-hmm. If I love the music and I love the people who are doing it, man, you know, I'll go and do the show or do the gig.
Yeah, that just comes off you, you know. And it's inspiring to be around. And also, you just add so much to whatever flavor game you're participating in.
I'm just listening and trying to, you know, react to what's happening in the moment. So
I love it. This is a great little segue to, speaking of For the Love of Music, we're going to play a song called Spring Fling right now that I wrote with a friend of mine named Travis Nicholson, and it debuted last year around this time when we had the first annual Spring Fling. That's what that poster behind me, that over there, let's see if I can do this in the mirror. You can see a little bit of the poster that we made. My wife Randa hand-painted that. That was the banner for the original Spring Fling. And that original celebration was very much in the line of this, just like getting people together to have fun playing music and being creative. It was also just that there was comedians, there was an improv troupe. It was wild. It was like basically an East Nashville talent show. And even though we have too much going, and homemade ice cream is kind of a thing I do. It was just like an amazing afternoon on a Sunday. And so we're doing it again. And that's happening next weekend, April 23rd. I'll probably put the date up there on the screen in case people are watching this from Nashville who want to come. And we're putting together the lineup right now, and all the proceeds go to an advocacy group called Voices for a Safer Tennessee, which is a nonpartisan coalition that's promoting sensible gun laws in the wake of this terrible local tragedy we had at the Covenant School. So it's going to be really fun. And there's a house band this year. DeMarco's going to be in the band. Yes. Nick's not going to be in the band because he's too good for that.
He's beyond that.
No, he's out of town. But it was his idea too. Yeah. He set it in motion. He's like, we got to have a house band. And then I was like, all right, we're doing it. And he's like, I'm going to be gone.
How many songs? Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Full of that town. Woo! All right, fellas. Let's
talk about 60 songs.
I go like this. Maybe something from the high shelf. It's been a couple years since I felt like myself. I've been staring out the window like a discount mannequin, wondering if I'm ever gonna see my friends again. Ah, but old man Winter, he's dead and gone.
And life's too short to wait too long. And the world's been turning from gray to green. I finally got a good feeling, and I'm looking for a spring flame. Spring flame. I got a couple friends that I barely ever seen. It's hard to get to know a person when you're tapping at them through a screen. What we need around here is some real life of living. Yeah, so come on everybody and get in where you fit in. I said I really want to see you, but I need some help. I can't throw this party all by myself. So bring what you got and leave what you're not. We'll figure the rest out at spring flame, yes. Spring flame. I see a chip, I saw a pretty face standing over by the ice cream scat solo. I think I might have seen him try to steal a glance back at me. I swear I came for the hang and the sunny weather. But you never know what's gonna happen when people get together. No, you don't. Well, it's been a little while since I took a chance, but now I'm walking right towards it like a man in a trance. And the crickets are singing about the birds and bees, and the, 'cause it's a natural thing. So let's be natural things at spring flame.
Was in the spirit of flinging. All right.
Spirit of flinging.
Living a life full of dreams, fellas. That's what we're doing here.
Korby, you got 9 minutes.
Okay, cool. This is the perfect amount of time. Well, let's just do this one more, guys. Yeah. And do you have anything like something that you'd love to have happen in the future, or something you're aiming at, or something that, or is it more just like, hey, keep on serving it up, more of the same?
Well, I have a very, very strong love and desire to create. I've always done that. In fact, when I was probably in my teens or so, I didn't aspire as much to be a player as I did to be a songwriter and a producer and things.
Yeah.
And so I've been doing I've been off the road, like serious touring, for going on 15 years.
Yeah.
And so I've used that time to install myself in Nashville and in the local scene, and do production and things like that. But what I also discovered is that I still love to play.
Yeah.
And so I will always play live somewhere, but I also want to be behind the scenes, and getting opportunities over the last maybe 6 or 7 years to do that more and more.
Mm-hmm.
It's just a love of music, man.
Yeah, brother.
It always comes back to that.
Yeah. So you're working on more production stuff
and absolutely, man.
More forest than trees.
Yeah. Maybe. Yeah. You know,
mixed in with the trees.
Probably mixed in with the trees.
Yeah, yeah. Can't have one without the other.
Yeah, I mean, with me, because I'm always inspired and challenged. And another part of what I'm learning is that I love to mentor younger musicians.
Sure.
I've been doing that very actively for the last decade around Nashville.
Yeah.
And so you hear a lot of kids who, I call them kids, they're adults, ladies and gentlemen, but they call me Uncle D. And so I've embraced that part of I guess my call or my passion as well.
Sure. And is there any kid that you're particularly excited about that you just want to throw out that we should check out?
All of them. All of them. I mean, mostly it's musicians and side uh-huh. men and women. But, man, they're all fantastic.
So nice to know that the new generation's coming up.
Oh, like, my goodness.
It's always going to...
And, you know, and it challenges me. It actually keeps my fire lit to want to continue to not let the rust build up too much on these.
Yeah.
Because I always tell them, I said, man, you're great, man. What you're doing is going to be great. But and you fly high, but you look to your right, and Uncle D will be flying right next to you.
Nice. Look at you, dude. Yeah, man, you're one of the most nurturing souls I've ever met. So.
Well, I so certainly aspire to be that.
Yeah. Well, you've nurtured me plenty. And you're gonna carry me home on this one, I think.
Well, I'll do my best.
I think we're all going to do our best on this one. You guys put on your capos too if you want.
Right, yeah. Snap.
That's a little. All right. Okay. Vanity check. All right. Hey, man, thank you so much for being part of this. This has been so fun.
My pleasure.
I love
Thanks
it.
Thanks for having me.
Any excuse to see you. And it sounds like we're going to get together in about 10 days.
We'll be spring flinging.
We'll be together. Flinging. We'll be flinging. thank you guys for tuning in. Nick Bearden on bass, DeMarco Johnson on keys, Kyle Noctegal behind the console there making us all sound good. And we'll see you next week with special guest Andrew Leahy. And stay passionate. Okay. Billy Ray was a preacher's son. When his daddy would visit, he'd come along. When they gather around, they start talking. That's when Billy would take me walking. Out through the back door, we go walking. Then he'd look into my eyes. Lord knows to my surprise, he only who could ever reach me was the son of a preacher man. The only one who could ever teach me was the son of a preacher man. Yes, he was. He was. Yes, he was. Being good and always easy, no matter how hard I try. When he started sweet talking to me, he come and tell me everything is alright. He kiss and tell me everything is alright. And could I get away again tonight? The only one who could ever reach me was the son of a preacher man. Yes, the only one who could ever teach me was the son of a preacher man. Yes, he was. He was. Yes, he was. I remember the look that was in his eyes, stealing kisses from me on the side, taking time to make time, telling me that it's all mine, learning from each other's knowing, looking to see how much we've grown. And the only one who could ever reach me was the son of a preacher man. The only one who could ever teach me was the son of a preacher man. Yes, he was, yes, he was. Yeah, the only one who could ever be. It was a sweet talking son of a preacher man. Yes, the only one who could ever teach me. Baptized son of a preacher man. Yes, it was, yes, he was, yes, he was.
Made it through the week and you didn't get punched. World's gone crazy, but I got a hunch we'll all feel better after Friday lunch.